To match the stars, Vic Gautier, Barbara Stewart, Jack Carter, Joanne Pflug, Richard Dawson, and Shelley. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, hello there. How do you do? Thank you very much. Hey, listen, it's a pleasure to have all of you with us. And in order to make the record perfectly clear, ladies and gentlemen, we must say that very pretty actress type lady, Barbara Stewart, is married to that pretty actor type man, Dick Gautier.
Yes.
We had to tell everybody we wanted to do that. Have to make that perfectly
clear. For a while, anyway. Before that, it was just fun.
And greet everybody. Shelley, haven't seen you in a while. What have you been up to?
I've been reducing.
You have?
I've been dieting.
But you've made a film recently, haven't you?
Yes, I know. I played a whale. No.
So that's it.
That was Poseidon Adventure, and I had to be fat, which I really didn't want to do. I don't like to eat. And
that's all over.
Yes, that's all over with.
Okay. All right. Nice to have you with us. And here we go. Is everybody ready to play?
Yeah. Sure.
Well, then let's say hello to our two players, Jeff Nichols and Joan DeYoung. Hello there. Those of you who were with us last time will remember that Jeff has already won $700. He's got a total of two games under his belt, and we're into the game. As a matter of fact, we had played one round, hadn't we? And Jeff is leading 3-0. And we're going to go to the second and final round, and Joan, you're going to have to match three of our celebrities to stay in the running there. We'll see if that happens right after this. Okay, here we go with round two. Are you ready? I will push the button. And remember, Joan, you must match three celebrities to stay in the running. You're the challenger. You'll make the selection. So if you would, please.
I'll take A.
A it is. All right, everybody plays, and here we go. Helen said to Peter, "Why didn't you tell me the blank was wet?" Did you hear that, Joan? Helen said to Peter, "Why didn't you tell me the blank was wet?" All right. As soon as you finish, you are finishing. Okay, everybody's finished up there. So, Joan DeYoung, we call for your response. Why didn't you tell me the...
floor.
The floor was wet, is her response. Let's see if that scores for her. Remember, you must match three celebrities to stay in the game. Dick Gautier will begin with you. She's looking for the answer, floor.
Well, I grew up in Southern California. We used to, you know, go and watch the Grunion and all that kind of thing. So I said sand.
The sand was wet. I see. Okay.
A little kind of...
his answer there. Okay, Barbara Stewart, what do you say?
A very female answer.
A very female?
Baby.
The baby was wet. Yes, that is a female answer indeed. And it's a pretty good answer, too. Okay, Joan DeYoung is looking for the word floor, Jack.
I got a few older kids, but they have less control, so I said that the...
All right. Now, Joan, we're getting to the moment of truth here. You must match the remaining three celebrities to stay in the game. Joanne Pflug, she's looking for the word floor. Why didn't you tell me the floor was wet?
Well, I was thinking of the park in New York City, and so I put the bench was wet.
The bench was wet. So our winner is Jeff Nichols. Congratulations. Oh, look at that. I see that Richard and Shelley held up their cards. They had floor. You missed it by one, Joan. You're a good sport, and therefore we've got a gift for you. Many thanks, Joan DeYoung, for being with us on Match Game 73. All right. This is your third game, right? This is happy Jeff Nichols over here. He's very happy because he's won his third game, and now he's going to have a chance at the big money again. The Super Match, are you ready?
I'm going to try.
Okay, now, as you know, we polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank guard. Or blank guard. I'll give you the accent both ways. The answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Your celebrities will help you. You'll choose three, get their responses, and then pick one of those or use one of your own if you like. The money you win up here will be yours to keep, and then you'll have a go at the big money. Are you ready? All right, let's choose some celebrities here now.
Joanne Pflug.
Joanne, what do you say?
I'm split between two, so I'll go with the first one, lifeguard.
Lifeguard is her answer. All right, another celebrity, Jeff?
Jack Carter.
can you mention a commercial product?
Well, I don't know. If you think...
I hate to...
If you think that studio...
I swear I'm receiving nothing. That's...
Jack, the only guidance I can give you is this. If you think the studio audience said that, then you say it, if you really believe that.
Really?
Yeah.
No, well, then I'll go with safeguard.
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 All right, that's his answer. You got two now.
Richard Dawson.
What do you say, Richard?
Well, I know it's something that Jack hasn't been given. Obviously, I would have thought right guard.
Right guard. Okay.
Nothing personal, Jack.
I can smell it from here.
So your celebrities have given you lifeguard, safeguard, and right guard. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own, but right now, Jeff, we've got to have an answer.
Lifeguard.
Lifeguard it is. The audience seems to agree with you. Let's see what happens. We are looking for lifeguard. May we see the $100 response? National Guard is the first one. No one gave you that. Still looking for lifeguard. May we see the $250 response? Lifeguard it is. There you go, Jeff. You got the $250. Okay. Joanne Pflug gave you lifeguard because she's a pretty smart lady there. Okay. Now that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, $2,500. Now we are going for the big money. First, let's reveal the $500 response. Right guard it was. Okay. Two of them up there thought of it. Richard gave it to you. Okay,
just
now, to collect your $2,500, you've got to match one celebrity head to head. All right, would you choose a celebrity now, please?
Joanne Pflug again.
All right, Joanne, you get ready to write. You face me. I'll get the question. All right, Joanne, you write your answer to this. Scarlet Blank. Scarlet Blank. Okay, Joanne is finished. Now, Jeff, we call for your response to Scarlet Blank.
Scarlet O'Hara.
All right, Joanne. For $2,500, may we see your answer?
Well, I'm from Atlanta, Georgia, so I put Scarlet O'Hara.
Scarlet O'Hara! And Joanne is very happy for you, too.
That is great.
Okay, congratulations to you. He says his sister and mother, his whole family is down there, and the audience jumping up and down and praising the praises of Scarlett O'Hara. Where are you from?
New Orleans.
Well, I guess it had to be Scarlett O'Hara. All right, you're going to meet another player, Jeff, and continue as long as you're our champ, and that'll happen right after this. We've got one happy winner here who's won $3,550 to date. Let's say hello now to his challenger, Dottie Bird. Hello, Dottie.
Hello.
You're a very pretty lady. You want to tell us a little about yourself, where you're from and all that?
Okay. I manage a dental office in Huntington Beach. I'm 24 years old, and I love to paint.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You paint in oils and all that?
Yeah.
And you manage a dental office?
Yes.
I got this.
Oh!
I guess we better do that at some other time. Now, Dottie, you know how to play the game? Let me just review briefly. The two of you are going to be answering questions here and attempt to match our six celebrities. You'll get two chances. The one who does that the most at the end of the second and final round will win, gets $100, and the opportunity to go on for the super match where you can win over $5,000. All right, I will push the button down, and that means we're ready to go to round one. Dottie, would you please make a selection?
B.
B is what she says. Brand new game, so everybody plays.
Oh, shut up. You heard the enthusiasm.
Frank said, I'm sick and tired of that dog blanking on my favorite chair. Frank said, I'm sick and tired of that dog blanking on my favorite chair. And he said it just like that.
Spelling doesn't count.
Spelling doesn't count. But let me just check it anyway for... No, I'm only kidding. Spelling really doesn't count here at all. We'll figure out the meaning, and if it matches, it matches. Bottom tier is ready. Dick, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Jack Carter is ready, so we'll call for a response from Dottie Berg now. Frank said, I'm sick and tired of that dog blanking on my favorite chair. What do you say, Dottie?
I'll be tame and say sitting.
Sitting on my favorite chair. That's her answer. What do you say, Dick Gautier? She's looking for the word.
Well, I said shedding.
Shedding.
I said shedding.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Sick and tired of the dog sitting on my favorite chair is her answer. Barbara Stewart, what's yours?
Gotcha.
Shelley's staring at me. Well, I dressed it up a lot. I said urinating.
You said that. I didn't hear anything.
She just did.
All right, Jack Carter.
Bleep that out.
Looking for the
Listen, I just found out I'm on the wrong game. I better leave. It's called the Weird Couple Show, right? Well, I never found a dog that ever sits up. Yeah. Mine usually is sleeping.
Sleeping.
And snoring as well.
Sick and tired of the dog sleeping on my favorite chair. Okay, no match yet. Sitting is the word. What do you say?
I have a spoiled dog, and she's always sitting in the chair.
Sitting! So you score, Dottie. There's one match for you. Now let's go to the sage himself.
I think we should all be grateful that Joanne can spell correctly. We could have all been in trouble. I also said sitting.
Sitting! There's another one. Now you're beginning to go, and let's see if you get one from Shelley Winters.
I had shedding. Shedding.
Shedding. Okay.
No more drinks.
All right. So you've scored twice there. And now let's go to Jeff Nichols, half of the round. With this, everyone participates. One caveman asked another, can I borrow your blank? One caveman asked another, Jeff, can I borrow your blank? All right.
I'm not ready yet.
Are you still thinking?
I'm thinking.
Well, you better start writing soon because the time is going to expire.
So is Miss Winter.
Did you get an answer, Jack?
Got one.
You got one. All right, let's get one from Jeff Nichols, our champ. One caveman asked another, can I borrow your...
Wife.
Wife.
Where do you live, in the valley? Yes.
Yes. All right. Let's. The word is wife from Jeff Nichols. One caveman asked another, can I borrow your wife? Let's find out what you said, Dick.
Borrow your club.
Your club.
Then I get your wife. Yeah,
then you get the wife. All right. Wife is what he wants. Barbara, what do you want?
Well, I thought of wife, but I thought of my caveman too, and I said club.
Club it is from Barbara Stewart. All right, Jack.
I think I'm becoming their offspring, you know. I also joined that club. Then you club your mate, then you get a wife.
Club, and she's looking for wife. Joanne?
He.
I beg your pardon. He. Yes.
Wife? I put club.
Well, we've got four clubs in a row so far. Now, let's go to Richard Dawson and see what he has to say about this.
Well, I would have suggested instead of a club, a nine iron, but I did put club.
So there's five clubs in a row.
Golfers here, obviously.
Let's see. Wife from Shelley Winters. You've got a wife from Shelley Winters, and there's one match. And we'll go to round two right after this.
Is that
Dottie Berg, the challenger, is ahead at the end of round one, 2-1. So now let's go to round two and ask her to make a selection.
I think I'll go for B again.
You'll go for B again. This is it. Now, you've matched two of our celebrities, Richard Dawson and Joanne Pflug, so now you'll be trying to match the others. Are you ready, others?
Yes. Certainly, yes.
John decided to get the blank taken off his chest. John decided to get the blank taken off his chest. It's easy, Shelley.
What kind of fellow is this, John?
I can give you no further information. Shelley, John decided to get the blank taken off his chest. All ready now. All right, Dottie, may we have your response?
Tattoo?
Tattoo is her answer. Sounds like a good one to me. Let's see what it sounds like to you up there.
I was gonna say hair, but that's George Maharis did that. No, this is tattoo. Is what I said.
One match for Dottie in this round. Tattoo is her word. What is yours, Barbara?
I guess I was thinking of George Maharis.
Yeah, hair. Hair is there. All right, Jack, we're looking
for
tattoo.
Well, I got the same problem. I don't have mohair. I have me hair.
I see.
And so I went for the
hair.
But there's no tattoos on chest.
Okay, now we'll go to Shelton Winters. Tattoo is what she's looking for. May we see yours?
Hair.
Hair. All right, you picked up one there. Now we'll go to the...
It sounded too painful.
...second half of this round. Jeff, I point out to you, you must match two celebrities to stay in the game. Three, however, will win the game for you. Here we go. Arthur was so blank, he couldn't get into Fanny's car. Arthur was so blank, he couldn't get into Fanny's car.
Accept these questions.
Three drunk in the back room.
Now, last time you matched Shelley, so this time everyone will participate except Shelley. Jack, you ready up there?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
A little trouble separating the cards.
All right. Now we'll call on Jeff for his response. Arthur was so blank he couldn't get into Fanny's car. What do you say?
Drunk.
Drunk is his word. He needs two to stay in the game. Three will win it. Dick.
I almost went for drunk, but I finally went for fat.
Fat.
Because I know Fanny's car.
Fat and drunk are all good answers. Now, fat. Barbara Stewart.
Fat.
Uh-oh, drunk is his word. Let's watch it here.
Well, I like to hear New Orleans people scream a lot, so I went for drunk.
Drunk. All right. You got one. You need one more to stay in the game. Okay, here we go with Joanne's answer. Drunk is what the word we're looking for.
Well, Jeff and I are Southerners, and we think alike, so I said drunk.
All right, you got one more chance to win the game. You're in it, however. Now let's call on Richard Dawson.
He's not home. Actually, I put fat because he was with child. I'm sorry to say.
So we've got a tie here, and that means we're going to have to go to a tiebreaker. And what we do here is we wipe the score clean and start all over. We're going to give you one question, and the person who has scored the greatest number of matches with our celebrities will be the winner. All right, Dottie Berg, would you make a selection?
B.
B. All right, everyone plays in this tiebreaker. Everyone, here we go. Name a TV news commentator. Name a TV news commentator.
Both names?
Well, just so we can identify them, Shelley. Have you thought of yours? Okay, we'll call on you in a moment. Bottom tier is ready. And the top tier is ready. Now, Dottie, we ask you to name a TV news commentator.
George Putnam.
George Putnam is what she says. He does the news out here. Let's find out if that score is up here, Dick.
I didn't know you were talking about actors. I went for a... I went for Cronkite. Walter Cronkite.
Walter Cronkite. Jerry Dunphy, another...
Yeah, I'm a Jerry Dunphy.
Jerry Dunphy. I guess those people are in Los Angeles, yeah. Aren't they? All right, now let's go down to Joanne Pflug. We're looking for George Putnam.
Walter Cronkite.
Walter Cronkite and Richard...
Putnam moved from Channel 11 to Channel 5 was they had a larger flag. I put Cronkite.
All right. And
Brinkley.
Shelley says Mr. Brinkley. So you did not score with that. Let's go to Jeff's half of the round and see what happens with this. Name a TV detective. Name a TV detective. We're getting close to the end, so do it as quickly as possible, if you please. TV detective. All right, everybody ready. Put it in the slot there, quickly. Okay, here we go.
The character hold it. Plays hold, his hold, name. Hold.
Jeff, may we have your answer, please?
Name Mannix. It.
Mannix is what he says. One match will win the game. Dick Gautier.
I said Cannon because my wife's doing the show next week.
All right. Barbara, Mannix is what we're looking for.
Well, how here. About a Mannix?
Mannix wins the game. There you go. Congratulations. All right. We'll get back in just one moment. But first, we've got...